Hey guys, Ninetales Commander here with episode 18 of Pokemon Battle Zone. I thank you very much for joining me on another episode. Apologies for not having one of these up in a little while. It's been a few days since the last episode, but we're back now, so let's get started. I lead off with my Ferrothorn, and he's got a Latios. This is another battle I had on the battle spot, and this guy was actually pretty decent, so here we go. He's going to go straight in for the Calm Mind, and I do set up my Stealth Rocks. I was thinking maybe he'd go for something like maybe Hidden Power Fire, or assuming Latios gets any other fire type moves, but he goes straight for the Calm Mind, so I get another set of Stealth Rocks, and then I just get up a substitute, and now I'm going to go straight in for the Toxic. Now, I am sort of in a midway type of situation here. He's got the Calm Mind going, but on my side I have got the substitute and of course the Toxic support, and he's going to go straight for the Dragon Pulse. This is definitely going to break my substitute, and so that's going to fade now. And I decided to go for the Gyro Ball this turn because it's the only move I have, and this will do quite a lot of damage because Latios is pretty fast and it actually does quite a lot of damage. And I was hoping the Toxic, the Poison might have taken it out that turn, but unfortunately it does not. But it goes out into his Landorus that actually looks pretty weird when it floats. I think I've talked about that previously, but I still think it looks pretty weird seeing that thing float. But it does get Levitate, I think. So I think that's probably the reason why it's floating like that. And he goes for Earthquake, but I do take it pretty well. Well, somewhat well. You know, not very well, but decently well. And I go for another Toxic because, well, why not? Go for another Protect because I might as well Toxic stall this thing out as much as I possibly can. He's going to go for another Earthquake that's going to fail due to the use of Protect, and he gets hurt by the poison. This turn I might as well Death Fodder my Ferrothorn because there isn't much else I can do, and I do actually survive. I did not think I survived that turn. It's been a few days since I had this battle, so please excuse the lack of memory. So I do actually survive, and for some reason he switched. I was actually pretty sure he'd go out and go for the Thunderous. Not the Thunderous, go for the Earthquake. Sorry, got a bit sidetracked there. And he goes out into his Thunderous and he's gonna Volt Switch, apparently. I'm not sure why Volt Switch. I guess he just wanted to switch out and go for whatever he has in the boot. So he brings in his Landorus, and it's gonna die pretty quickly. I don't know if Volt Switch was the best choice to go for there, because then he would have avoided that extra bit of damage for the poison. And I bring in Absol. I really need to get a better Absol, because this Absol does not have Justified. It really could do with that. You know, I know it doesn't really matter once it Mega Evolves, but Justified is still a lot better than Pressure. You know, it is definitely, for lack of a better term, it's much more justified to have Justified, if that makes sense to you. So he goes out into his Latios after KOing the Landorus, and he goes for the recover, and I thought, oh, okay, that means Sucker Punch is actually not going to work. So I figured, well, what can I do here? I could either keep going for Sucker Punch, but eventually I'm going to run out of power points. So then I thought, well, he's probably just going to keep predicting me going for the Sucker Punch. So I decided on this turn, oh, to go for another Sucker Punch. I actually do have a purpose behind doing this. I basically want to make him think that I'm just going to keep going for Sucker Punch. But on the next turn, I plan to go straight in for the Home Claws because, well, I just might as well. Now, it's funny because when I had this battle, I actually forgot that Mega Absol is actually pretty fast. It's actually really fast, and I didn't realize for a while that, in fact, Mega Absol actually is faster than Latios. So then I realized, oh, hang on a minute, I'm technically faster, so, you know, why don't I just go straight for Stone Edge? And I'm actually getting a bit ahead of myself. I actually do remember this part of the battle, so I thought, well, eventually I realized that I'm faster, so why don't I just go for Stone Edge? And I do finally go for Stone Edge this turn, and I should have done that right away. You know, it's because I'm still a bit new to this whole, you know, speed with, you know, Mega Evolutions. But he goes he brings out his Thunderous. I'm just going to go for another Stone Edge. That's definitely going to knock it out because I have a Home Claws boost. Plus it is Mega Absolutes, face it. And that's going to seal the match. So thank you very much for watching, my honourable viewer. You can click on this box right here that will take you to the previous episode if you have not seen it yet. And as for me, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Thanks for watching.